Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. Today, we're going to be spending some time on the EMC partner, MIL-MG3, conducted susceptibility test system designed for MIL standard 461 and DO-160 testing. We're going to start the video by going over some of the connections on the front and the back of the unit. Then we'll go ahead and we'll take a look at a few different setups. And then finally, we'll go ahead and start the system up and spend some time changing different testing criteria from the front panel display. During today's video, we're going to be referencing the user manual and other associated documentation, which can be found on our website, and I'll put a link for that in the description below. The MIL-MG3 system provides capabilities for a variety of different immunity testing requirements for both military and avionics. The capabilities can be switched by swapping out the module on the front of the system. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the military test systems brochure from EMC Partner and look at a few different modules that are available. Here's a list of the available plugins for the MIL-MG3 system. For today's video, we have the top three designed for MIL Standard 461 CS115 and MIL Standard 461 CS116 testing. As you can see, there is also capabilities for CS06, MIL Standard 1275, and DO-160 Section 17 and 19. Looking at the fourth module down, it's a custom frequency module for MIL Standard 461 CS116 testing. This allows for a selection of a frequency from 10 kHz all the way up to 30 MHz. During today's video, we're using the two set frequency modules, which tend to be the most common. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the front of the MIL-MG3 test system. Here's the front of the MIL-MG3 system. Let's go ahead now and let's start from the left side of the unit and let's work our way right. All the way in the top left, we have the display. And then just below that, a series of buttons and connections. In the lower left corner, we have the power button, USB port, and auxiliary connection for adding additional equipment. Next, we have four BNC inputs or outputs. And then finally, farthest on the right, in this series of connections, we have the BNC trigger output. Taking a look now, just to the right of the display, we have the run pause button, and then below that, the stop button. Taking a look just below those, we have our rotary knob. Finally, all the way on the right, we have the emergency stop. Just below that, we have the plug-in module section of the system, and this is where the different modules can be swapped out to provide different testing capabilities. Let's go ahead now, let's get the unit turned around, and let's take a look at the back of the system. Here's the back of the system. Starting from the left, we have our AC mains connection, as well as our off-on switch. Working our way right, we have the cooling fan. Just to the right of that, we have our auxiliary connection. And then next to that, our EUT power input, which can be required for specific plugins or modules. Along the right side of the unit, we have the control connections. We have our RS-485 interfaces, USB port, Ethernet interface, and then all the way on the bottom, our free BNC input or output connections. Let's go ahead now and take a look at the MIL Standard 461, CS115, and 116 setups using the MIL-MG3 test system. Here you'll find the system calibration setup with the MIL-MG3 test system following the diagram on page 34 of the user manual. Starting with the transient generator, we have the output from the MIL-3-REC module going to the input on the CN-BT6. To the left of that, on the input 2, we have our filter. As you can see, we have the CN-BT6 in the calibration fixture. And then we have two 20 dB attenuators placed on both sides. From there, you can see we have the cable going to our oscilloscope, which has two 20 dB attenuators connected to channel one. The test setup would be very similar to the calibration setup you can see right now, with the removal of the attenuators and calibration fixture and the addition of a monitoring probe. Now let's go ahead and let's take a look at CS116. Here is the CS116 calibration setup, and we're following the diagram, which is located on page 36 of the user manual. We have our MIL-3-30M-100M module installed in our MIL-MG3 system. And we have the output going to the input channel 2 of the CN-BT6 coupler. Beyond that, the setup will remain pretty much the same as CS115. One thing worth noting is that the filter is not used in this test setup or calibration for CS116. Now let's go ahead and let's get the system powered on and let's take a look at the display. All right, here's the starting display on the MIL-MG3 test system. As you can see, the active module is indicated with the green background. As we mentioned earlier, we have the 30M-100M module in our system today. As you look along the bottom kind of third of the screen there, it also gives you a brief description. Let's go ahead now and let's click on the 30M-100M. All right, here is our 30M-100M menu, which is commonly used for CS116 testing. You can see we have a series of different boxes along the left. We have waveform, level, polarity, and then finally, all the way on the bottom, we have level ramp. To the right of this, we have a graphic representation. These are fairly intuitive, these different menus. If we click on the waveform menu all the way at the top, it will display the 100 megahertz waveform also provided by this module. Let's go ahead now and let's hit the back button, which is in the upper right hand corner. And let's go back to our main menu here. Looking at the bottom now, we have level, time, and coupling. We're currently in the level menu. However, let's go ahead and let's click time. Here we have the different testing criteria along the left. We have test time, repetition, and trigger mode. And then we have a graphic description on the right. To change the different criteria on the left, you can just select the associated box. Let's go ahead and let's click repetition. And let's change it from 0.5 to 6 seconds. Excellent. You can see that changed on our menu right now. Finally, all the way along the bottom, we have coupling. Let's go ahead and let's select that. This shows the coupling network, our CN-BT6, as well as a brief diagram of the setup on the right. Again, for today's video, we're just using the CN-BT6, so we're gonna leave that as the coupling network. All right, that should complete the video today on the EMC Partner MIL-MG3 test system. We began the video by spending some time on the unit and the available modules. Then we moved to the test setups. And then finally, we walked through selecting different testing criteria using the front panel display. We hope this video has been useful, and please keep us in mind if you ever need to rent the EMC Partner MIL-MG3 test system.